Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. In this one, we're going to go over how to create a Facebook business manager, kind of a walkthrough of everything that's in there. So if you're here, it means that you're interested in running Facebook ads the right way. There's a wrong way. Maybe you didn't know there was a wrong way, or maybe you don't even know why you're here, or even if you need a Facebook business manager. Don't worry, we're going to cover all of those things. If this isn't the right video for you, just leave a like on your way out. Thank you so much. Just a quick plug before we jump into everything. If you're trying to figure out how to start any type of online business and you're confused by all the different courses, ads, and opportunities out there, please make sure you go to CourseRanks.com before you buy any courses. It's completely free to use and it ranks the top courses in each industry so you can make sure you make the best investment possible. All right, thanks for staying through that. And now let's get into the video. So a Facebook business manager is basically the power strip all your other business assets can plug into. So if you have a Facebook pixel, a Facebook page, and a Facebook ads manager, they're all going to plug into your business manager so you can manage them all in one spot. It also allows you to invite other people to look at your business assets and collaborate with you on them. So that's really powerful. And one thing we need to clarify before we jump into any technical stuff is you only need one business manager account. I made the mistake when I was starting out of creating a new one for each client that I brought on, which was a really bad call. So now I have like 8 business managers when I only actually needed one. So you just need one per business that you own. So if you're working with clients, they should create their own business manager or potentially not have one at all. They can just plug into your business manager. Facebook also recently came up with something new called Facebook Business Suite. The old business manager is still there and it's better for some things while the suite is better for others. So we'll cover both in this video. Just a quick analogy here. Facebook Business Suite is sort of like flying a plane with a really simple interface. You can fly, but you can't perform complex maneuvers. Facebook Business Manager is more like flying a fully functioning plane. I like Facebook Business Manager for this reason, but if you're just starting out, you might like the suite better for now. Okay, so first, if you don't have a business manager account, you're going to have to create one. You'll do that by going to business.facebook.com and then following what you see on the screen. I'm just putting a recording of when I did this about a year ago because I've done this so many times. I've created so many dummy accounts that Facebook will flag me as suspicious if I do that again. This is really easy. Just fill everything out. If you don't have a website yet, just put your Facebook URL. So it'd be facebook.com/yourbusiness. All right. Now, depending on how Facebook is feeling when you're watching this, you might see a page just like this that will have you create or connect your page, or you might be in Facebook Business Suite, or it might look completely different and they could change all of this next month. I want to help you in this tutorial to be able to help yourself, not just copy me exactly and then not really know what's going on. All right, so let's hop into my computer and see what happens for me. I'm here on an incognito tab and it's asking me if I'd like to log into Facebook Business Suite when I went to facebook.business.com because it knows that I already have an account. So I'm going to go sure and I'll sign into Facebook here. It looks like it's going to require me to get a 6-digit code. So we'll fast forward through this part and I'll click save browser here. All right, so it's put me on my Facebook Business Manager page because it knows I have this preference. So I'm gonna see if I can switch to Facebook Business Suite where Facebook will likely put you as a beginner. Okay, so what's funny here is it's actually not letting me access Facebook Business Suite, and it might be the same for you. And it could be that it doesn't let you access Facebook Business Manager. So I'll have to come out with a Facebook Business Suite video when I get access to that product. But for now, what we're going to go over is just Facebook Business Manager. So what I'll do is just put a little clip here where if you're in Business Suite, it'll teach you how to get out of Business Suite and into Facebook Business Manager, and then we'll go from there. All right, awesome. Here we are within the Facebook Business Manager. This is what you should see. This is kind of your dashboard, and we're going to go ahead and hop into something called Business Settings first, because that's where the majority of everything you're going to be doing will happen, and that's what you need to understand first. So come here to Business Settings. We'll wait for that to load, and basically this just allows us to manage all that other stuff that we saw earlier on the left-hand side, all in one spot. So what you'll see here is users. So we've got people, partners, and system users. So with people, I always end up adding them as admins because I just find I have to do that in the future anyway. They don't have sufficient permissions. And to go through and do that, so if you wanted to add somebody to this business manager, I'd click add, and then I type in their email here and I'd give them admin access. I can put that here. So let's say john@john.com, next. And then here what you can do, let's say I wanted to add this person to CourseRanks, I could add them to the page, give them permission to publish content as well as manage the page and view earnings insights. And then let's say I wanted to add them to the CourseRanks ad account as well. I could come in here and do the same thing. So I just click add, manage ad account, and that highlights all of these things here. Catalogs, apps, pixels. I could also add pixels in here. So we're going to add them to the CourseRanks pixel. And so then I just click next and it would send an email invitation to this guy, john@john.com, and he'd have access to everything here at CourseRanks. One thing to keep in mind when it comes to those emails is that they almost always go to spam for me. So make sure that you check your spam folder if you've sent that to someone. somebody. So that's how you integrate. That's what I was talking about earlier, where you can integrate between people. That's how you'd add them here. And then you add them to specific assets. But if you want to restrict access to specific assets, then you can do that as well. I typically just give full access to everybody I add to my business manager because I trust them wholeheartedly. So I just say, I don't want to have to deal with updating your permissions in the future. So just go for it, you know? All right. So that's people. Now let's check out partners here. And so the difference between people and partners is basically this will allow you to integrate directly with Facebook Business Manager, somebody else's business manager, instead of their Facebook personal profile. So if I click add here, it would say give partner access to your assets or ask a partner to share their assets. So I'd click here on give. So I just have to ask them for their business ID, which you can find depending on what the asset is. So if I go to pages, I could pull up the asset for that. So I'd come here and this is my, so for my page, Keaton Walker, I've got this ID. I could copy that, come back to partners, click add, give partner access to your assets. And then I would, you know, paste this in here and then click next. They would, you know, get a request for that thing. And then you can also set the permissions there as well. System users, this is more for developers. You probably won't deal much. I've never dealt with it. And I've been using Facebook Business Manager for the last almost 3 years now. All right, now moving on, we're going to be under accounts here and we've got pages. So you can see all the pages that your business manager has access to. Ad accounts, same thing. Pages are obviously what you're most familiar with. And then ad accounts, that's where you're going to be running the successful ads, the running ads the right way, right? So just to show you how this one works, we can click add, and then we can either add a page, request access to a page, or create a new page. So if you don't have a page yet, make sure you check out our video on how to create a Facebook business page. That will really help you. But if you already have your page and you want to add it to your business manager, which I would highly recommend, then you just come here to request access to a page, and you would type in, let's say, I think in that example, we did Keaton's escape room. So this was that Facebook page, and I'm just going to click publish content, all of this stuff. It's going to allow it to live inside my Facebook business manager. And then I would watch this. I'll click request access. And I was already given access to this page because my personal profile is an admin on that page. But if you look at this, no people are actually connected here, or partners for that matter. So what we do here is click add people. I'd scroll down to me here, and then I'm going to add all of these permissions here on the page and click assign. So that's the same exact thing that we did up here at people, except just reverse. So instead of adding a bunch of assets to one person, I just added one person to an asset. So now you can see I'm a person here. If I want to add more people, I can. If I want to remove this page, I can. If I want to view it, I can. So now moving on to ad accounts, this is pretty much the same thing. Let's say we wanted to add an ad account. We just asked for that ID. And then again, that would link personally into ours. A lot of times what I do for my clients is I just create a brand new one for them. So they'll come here, we'll name it the right thing. We'll go through this whole process of creating that new ad account and adding it into our business manager. You know, putting in a payment method, putting in the currency, all of that stuff so that we can actually run ads through that ad account. But we say, hey, we're creating this on behalf of another client. All right. So business asset groups, I'm going to be honest, I haven't used this one at all really. So I think you'll be fine if you just stick with pages and ad accounts. Instagram accounts, you can come here and click add. So we don't have the CourseRanks Instagram account yet in our business manager. So what I'm going to do here is click switch accounts and CourseRanks, put in our password here, and there you go. Boom. It's connecting our CourseRanks Instagram account to our business manager now. And now it's asking which ad account it wants me to connect it to. So I'm going to come here and click CourseRanks, click finish, done. Awesome. So now that's connected. It doesn't have any partners connected to it yet. So now if I come here and click assign partners, I can enter the business ID. We don't really need to assign partners here because it's already just under the umbrella of my business manager. And so I'm going to leave that there. Lines of business and WhatsApp accounts, I haven't used these. They could potentially become more important in the future. But again, in 3 years, I haven't had to use them. So they can't be that important, right? All right, now we've covered users and accounts. Let's go on to data sources. So we've got catalogs. I haven't used this. So the main thing you're going to use here is pixels and custom conversion. So if we come here to pixels, you'll notice that we have CourseRanks pixel here. We're going to come out with a video soon about how to create a pixel. So make sure you watch for that. But if I wanted to click add, I'm creating a brand new pixel here and I go through that process, right? But if I come in here to CourseRanks pixel and click open in events manager, it's going to open that in a new tab for me. I could have come here the same exact way if I just came back to this original business home here and I also clicked events manager. It's going to take me to the same exact page here. So I can check out my CourseRanks pixel here, see the different analytics that we've had going on. We just recently reintegrated this, so there's not a ton of traffic on here yet, but that's kind of where you see what's going on with your Facebook pixel. And then if we go back to business settings where we were before, we can look at custom conversions. So these are all the custom conversions that I've set up in the past. Obviously, they're named specific things here because they had to do with the business. business that was created for at the time. If we come in here to Events Manager, you're going to see custom conversions again. You'll see all these same custom conversions, just kind of in a different interface. So I could click here, assign partners to this custom conversion, or I can come into Events Manager and click in here and see. So then I can come in here and say, okay, between March 24th and April 21st, 17 people have taken this specific action, and the last one was 6 days ago. 93 on the page views here, so you know, all of that. So this is where you'd live for custom conversions and partner integrations. If you're using something like any of these softwares that are on here, you can integrate them and then everything that you need to see in one spot here in Business Manager. All right, moving on. So that's everything you need to know about data sources. Brand safety, I haven't really dealt with this at all. You should be fine as long as you don't touch anything here. Registrations, nothing. Integrations. So leads access, if you're running lead ads, this is a very niche case, just look it up, but this is where you would integrate that and make sure that you have access to the leads that are actually coming through. If we come here to payment methods, you're absolutely going to need this if you want to be running ads. So you come in here and click add a new payment method or request access to a partner's credit. So if somebody has some sort of credit with Facebook ads, then you can request access to that if you're spending on their behalf. So if we come here to Security Center, this is where we can come to turn on two-factor authentication, backup admin, all of this kind of stuff. Requests, this is where we would see invitations that we've sent or received for people to join our Business Manager. Notifications, I would just come in here and turn, I have a few of these on, but I have a lot of them off because I don't like getting a lot of notifications, especially via email, for things that I just don't care about that aren't that important within, you know, you have to kind of remove the noise so that you can pay attention to the signal, because there's so many different notifications that you can get from Facebook Business Manager. Then we've got business info. The more you fill out here, the better. And then lastly, setup guide. This would just be things that you could walk through Facebook, or, you know, we've pretty much done the setup guide in here with a more candid outline of what you actually need within your Facebook Business Manager. All right, that was business settings. So now let's go back to this front page and just go over everything in here. So we've got Ads Manager. This is going to be really important. Audiences, ads reporting, ad account settings. So we already covered Events Manager. Let's just go over audiences first, and then Ads Manager, ads reporting, and ad account settings all go together. So we'll do those together. So if I click here on audiences, it's going to take me to a place where I could create specific audiences for whatever it is I'm advertising. So if I come here to audiences, there's other ways to create these, but if I click create audience, I can create a custom audience, a lookalike audience, or a special ad audience. So a custom audience would be something like taking all of the emails that you have on file for your different users or customers or whatever your business is about, uploading those to Facebook, and then saying, hey, I want to run ads to these people because they've already expressed interest. And so Facebook will target just those people. But let's say that's a really small group and you want something a little bit bigger, then you could come to lookalike audience and you could do the same thing. Except when you create a lookalike audience, you're taking the data from your custom audience and then you're telling Facebook, hey, I want the 1% of people on Facebook that look the most like all these people on this list, or you can go all the way up to 10%. And that creates a lookalike audience, which you can then advertise to. So Facebook, you know, has a lot of data on people, their behaviors, their interests, all of that. And when you give them a little bit of data and say, hey, I want people that look somewhat like this, then Facebook's able to go through all of its users and show the ads to the right people. Awesome. So that was audiences. Now let's go into Ads Manager. So here we are in Ads Manager, and what it's doing is it's showing us the CourseRanks ad account. If you have multiple ad accounts, you just click up here and you can kind of scroll through those and switch to each ad account. I'm not going to go over everything about Ads Manager right now because we're coming out with a video that actually teaches you how to use it. And that's much more effective than me just sitting here talking at you about how it's useful. Just a few things. Campaigns, this is kind of the top level. This is where everything stems from. Ad sets. So campaigns, this is kind of the shell that your ad sets and your ads live within. Ad sets, this is where you target the right people with your Facebook ads. And then ads, this is the creative. This is actually what you're putting into your ads that people are seeing on their feeds. So that's a quick breakdown of what we've got here. Let's go back to home. Next, we're going to check out ads reporting. So if we wanted to run a report of the ads and send it to a client, for example, we'd come in here, click create report, select the ad account that we want to do, and then click create. And then it's going to run a report. We can use all of this pivot table, trend line chart, bar chart, all of this stuff, and then just send it to our client. Awesome. So that was ads reporting. Now let's jump into ad account settings. This is just going to be another little settings box. So here in ad account settings, we've got ad accounts, pages, payment settings, notifications, and name templates. So name templates, you might be able to create a template for every single campaign you create or ad set you create or whatever it is. And here on ad accounts, it's basically just pointing you to opening payment settings or taking you over to business settings, which we went over in the first part of this video. Pages, we will come here and it'll show you all of the pages that you have access to. And then if you click on those pages, it will just take you to them and then you can access them within Facebook Business Manager. And I'm glad we kind of ended here because you might not recognize this. So we've got this gray bar up at the top, right? That means that we're within Facebook Business Manager, but we're managing this page. If you weren't within Facebook Business Manager, you would have a blue bar at the top. But because it's gray, we know that we're in Facebook Business Manager. And so we're going to have different options here within managing the page. All right. And then lastly, we're just going to go over one other thing, which is all tools here. This is a really big menu with a lot to focus on. So we're not going to dive into it because most of these things, I'm going to be honest, guys, I've never used. What I've showed you today, that's the 10, 15% that you need to focus on. And the rest of this is pretty much just extra. Just make sure you're running ads, you're getting customers. That's the most important thing when it comes to Facebook Business Manager. But if you ever need, or you just want to play around with these extra settings, you can come check them out in all tools just by clicking on these 9 little dots right here. All right, that's it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. As you can see, Facebook Business Manager isn't quite as complex as it might seem. You just have to know what to focus on. So I really hope I've helped you with that today. If I did, please leave a like on this video, comment down below any questions you have. I'll try to get back to you. And again, make sure if you're interested in any online courses or growing an online business to check out CourseRanks.com before you buy anything. It's completely free to use and it could absolutely change your life. And just one final plug here is that this video is part of a series of videos about Facebook ads, Facebook pages, business manager, all these things. So make sure you check out the other videos in this series if you want to set everything up correctly. And with all of that said, I will see you next time.